The first one talked by about Bola was to protect the palace area, which is the metropolis, against external aggression. Then his great-great-great-great-great-great-great-grandson, Oba Eware, like I told you, the one who had a usurper brother that Imotan helped, he became the greatest Oba. He conquered 201 towns and villages. He expanded the kingdom to become an empire, conquering up to Asaba, conquering up to the Yoruba lands and all that. Now, the wolves were dogs. They used to dress them periodically so that the place could be smooth and very difficult to climb.
Slopy.
Yes, slopy and steepy and slippery. Mm. So, these moats, they are the largest man-made earthwork in the world, as in the Guinness Book of Records. It took about 150 million hours to dig, by estimation, and they were dug physically by the Benin people. It is three times longer in size than the China Wall, the Great Walls of China, and two times bigger than Songbo's Eredo. That's another artifact. But essentially, the moat was a defensive mechanism, and it predates the use of modern earth-moving equipment. So you can see that it's a wonderful wonderful achievement, awesome, that humans actually dug this with their bare hands. That is why the Benin Moat is famous. It has become a cultural artifact and a tourist destination. This is the famous Benin Moat. It goes round, look at it, circumferences the metropolis, the palace area. And there's a wider one too that goes round, which was dug by Oba Eware the Great.